Hey everybody. Some of you may remember that I mentioned that I had a baseball card collection. And that I had hoped to do a video on it sometime. So consider this the first of a series of baseball card videos. Now, I have a lot of baseball cards, and I really think I could probably make 100 videos just on baseball cards. For you see, my collection may not be a what you would call a quality collection. It is definitely a collection of quantity. So in this video, I thought I would just show you a few of the cards. Excuse me while I take a drink. Now, as many of you know, baseball cards, for the most part, especially baseball cards from the 90s, are not worth very much. The bottom dropped out of the market when it comes to baseball cards because they were overproduced. And a lot of the cards I have at one time were considered very valuable. Is a Raphael for Cal. This is a 1999 Bowman Chrome. Here's a 99 Bowman Chrome of Corey Patterson. He played for the Cubs at this time. Now, at one time, this card was worth $40. I haven't followed baseball cards in many, many, many years. I haven't the slightest clue as to the value of this card. And I really don't know if it even has a value. Take, for example, this card. This is an Upper Deck Johnny Bench, Joe Morgan autograph card. They made 2,500 of these, and this one is numbered 538. Now, at one time, many years ago, this card was valued at over $600. But these days, I wouldn't be surprised if it has no value. And you can see I have this stored in a large acrylic block. But it may not be necessary these days to take such good care of it. I'm not sure. Now here's a 2000 Bowman card of Josh Hamilton. This is a refractor card. And it's a very nice card. And once again, I have no idea if it even has a value. Here's the FLIR. They made 2,000 of these, and this is number 1815. And I don't even remember half of these players. But at one time, this card was valued at $50. And once again, it may not be worth anything now. Here's a FLIR card, a showcase card. It's got this signature of Alex Rodriguez on it. And once upon a time, this card was valued at $250. And what you're looking at on this card is the sweet spot of an autographed Major League Baseball Alex signed the baseball, and they took the skin of the baseball and put it onto this card. If any of you guys know what these cards are worth, feel free to leave it in the comments. I'd be very interested in knowing if there's still any value whatsoever with these cards. Here's a Cal Ripken card. This is a Topps card, autograph. Here's a FLIR card of Ray Durham of the Chicago White Sox. And this little square is a piece of wood from one of the bats that he used in a game. And at one time, this card was valued at $25. So this card has a piece of a baseball bat that this guy used in one of his games. It may not be worth anything now. Here's a Upper Deck baseball card of a Ty Cobb, who played outfield for the Tigers. And this is a, what they call a piece of history. Card, and this is a piece of a baseball bat. It's 100% authentic game used bat by Ty Cobb. So Ty Cobb actually used the bat that this piece of wood was taken from. And same story. Many years ago, this was worth something. But probably not much today. Okay. I don't know how this got in here. This is a football card. Brett Favre, Green Bay Packers. And here's a piece of a football. This circular piece is taken from a football that he used during a game. So it's kind of like a souvenir card. And here's another game-used piece of a baseball. Okay. And this one was, this is from a baseball that Ken Griffey Jr. hit. I mean, everybody's heard of Ken Griffey Jr. This card was made by Upper Deck. And he was playing for the Reds at this time. I've got this sticker on here, but I don't have a value written on here. So there's a piece of a baseball hit by Ken Griffey Jr. Here's an autograph card. Harmon Kilbrew. It's got his signature on it. And they made a couple thousand of these, and this is number 78 of a couple thousand. And I think this card was valued at, I don't know, $30 or $40 at one time. And this is a Donruss card. Okay. Here's another one of the Fleer cards that has the sweet spot from a game-used baseball. This time by the ball was used by Greg Maddux. At this time he was pitching for the Atlanta Braves. And as you can see, at one time this card was valued at $150. And it's probably worth nothing today. Like I mentioned a few minutes ago, it's been years since I've even looked at these things. And since then, the bottom has fallen out of the market. Cards that were once worth a lot of money became virtually worthless practically overnight. Here's an Alex Rodriguez card. And it's a 94. He was playing for the Mariners. It's a nice looking card. So Robin Ventura card, and this card has a small piece of one of the jerseys that he wore in a game, and he was playing for the New York Mets, third base. And this is a Fleer showcase card. And at one time, this card had a value of about $40. Let's mix in a little bit of some more football with this. Here's another Brett Favre card when he played for the Green Bay Packers. And this particular card has a piece of the jersey, of a jersey that he actually wore in one of the games that he played with the Packers. And it's a pretty big piece of jersey, it looks like. Now here's a Tony Gwynn autograph card, and he was playing for the Padres at this time, and they didn't make very many of these at all. This is number 3 of 19, and there's Gwynn's autograph, and this card was pretty valuable at one time. It was once valued at $600. It's been a long time since I've looked at any of these, and I'm sure this card is not valued anywhere near this today. I'm sure it's probably a fraction of what it used to be. It's probably $10 or something like that. Here's another Tony Gwynn card, and it's a pretty nice card. It's a Vanguard 2000. It's a good looking card. Here's a J.D. Drew Fleer Ultra card. And at one time, the value of this card was about $50. It's probably 50 cents now. And this card has a piece of one of his jerseys that he wore in a game right here. And here's another one of the game used baseball cards. And this one is Andrew Jones, who played outfield for the Atlanta Braves back during that time. And this is a piece of a baseball that that he actually hit during a game. This is a upper deck card. And here's a Chipper Jones baseball card. Man, there weren't many of these either. I think there were 99 of these, and this is number 91. And at one time, this card had a value on it of about $40. And this is a 2000 card. Here's a Paul Molitor card. It's a Fleer. And here's a piece of a jersey that Molitor wore during one of the games that he played. I don't know if this is from the jersey. I don't think it's from the jersey that he wore when he hit his 3,000th hit on September 16th, 1996. But nevertheless, it's a nice card. Okay, now here's another jersey card, and it's another Tony Gwynn card, and it's a piece of a jersey that he wore in a game, and this is one of the Fleer Mystique cards, and it's numbered. This is number 254 of 435. And at one time, this card was had a value of about $100. You know, I probably have enough of these game-worn jersey cards to sew together a pretty nice baseball jersey. And here's a Sammy Sosa card. And, of course, we all know about what happened to Sammy back in the day. Obviously, this card was before the steroids. And at one time, this card had a value of about $100 on it. And this card was made by Fleer. As you can see, we're approaching a half hour on this video, and I've only gone through just a very small section of one row of one of these drawers, and there's more drawers above this that you cannot see because of the camera angle. And on top of that, I have boxes and boxes of cards and binders of hand-collated sets, and oh, it's just so much, you just wouldn't believe it. Okay. And here's a piece of a jersey worn by Cal Ripken Jr. And of course everyone knows he played for the Orioles. And I was actually at the game where he, in my opinion, I don't think it's an opinion, it's a fact. He had the best game of his life. And in that game, if I recall, he went 6-for-6. And the Orioles were playing the Atlanta Braves. And I was at that game, and it was a great game. Best game of his career, I believe. And at one time, this card with a piece of Ripken's jersey on it was worth about $120. I'm sure it's worth probably $1.20 now. Here's a piece of a baseball glove. A glove that was used by Ken Griffey Jr. And this is an Upper Deck Most Valuable Player card. It's a souvenir card that, you know, piece of his baseball glove on it. Here's a Bernie Williams card. And it's kind of a unique looking card, the way it's shaped. And this is a made by Topps. Here's a Sandy Alomar card, and another unique shape, and made by Topps, and Alomar was playing for the Indians at this time. And here's a Mark McGwire card. And this is another that was caught up in a steroid scandal. At one time, this card was worth about $60. It's kind of a unique looking card with this I don't know what that is. It's interesting, part of a batting cage, I'm not sure. Here's a piece of a baseball bat that was used by Ken Griffey Jr. And this card was made by Upper Deck. And at one point, the value on this card was $200. Pretty nice card. Probably worth about $2 today. Some of you guys that follow baseball cards, I don't follow this stuff anymore, so if you know what the value of some of these cards are today, please, by all means, leave a comment telling me what you know about it. Here's Larry Walker. And this card was made by Topps. And he played for the Rockies at that point in his career. Well, that's a pretty card. Made by Fleer. This is 24 karat gold right there. It says 3 of 24. It's 1999 Fleer. 3 of 24. So I can't help but wonder if any of this stuff has any value. Probably not. And here's another one of the Fleer. I guess they call these brilliance. 24 karat gold. Barry Bonds of the San Francisco Giants. Everyone knows that he played outfield. And this is number 10 of 24 produced. That's a nice looking card. And, this says Ty Cobb, 1909. Obviously, this card wasn't produced in 1909. This is made by Upper Deck. And, it's just kind of like a legend card to kind of tell people about one of the greatest players of all time. I actually have a room in my house with a piece of artwork of Ty Cobb hanging on the wall. And 1909, here's Honus Wagner. And all of you that know anything about baseball cards know that a real McCoy Honus Wagner card from way back is worth gazillions of dollars. Obviously, this isn't one of those. This was made by Upper Deck. And it's just another one of these cards, that legend type card. Here's another one of the Fleer brilliance. This is Nomar Garcia-Opera. I'm looking for one of the other brilliance that I've already laid down. Do you see the difference in these two cards, color-wise? The one on the right says 24 karat gold at the top. And also, let's see, they're both numbered. Nomar's card is number 53 of 99, but Barry Bonds' is number 10 of only 24. And these cards, both of these were made by Fleer in 1999. Here's a Roberto Clemente card. He's playing for the Pirates. It's kind of a old school card here. This is Roberto got his 3,000th hit in 1972. Here's another card made by Fleer. This is from the Fresh Ink series. It's an autograph card. And this one has an autograph of Andrew Jones on it. And at one time, this card had a value of about $60. And it's probably about 6 cents today. Okay, here's another Jersey card. And this one has a piece of Troy. Oh, how do you pronounce his name? Gloss. Anaheim Angels third base during this time. This is a Fleer showcase card that one time had a value of about $40. Here's another Andrew Jones card, and this one has a piece of his jersey on it. This is a Fleer showcase card that was once valued at about $50. This card came out in 2000. I'm sorry, it's a Fleer 2000. Yeah, came out in 2000. I have forgotten. A lot about these cards. It's been so long since I've even looked at them. And here's a Topps Future Stars. It's Bob Bonner and Cal Ripken and Jeff Schneider. This is a 1982 Topps Future All-Stars. Let's take another look at that. And here's an autograph card of Bob Gibson. This is one of the Sports Illustrated cards made by Fleer. And it's got Bob Gibson's autograph on it. A certificate of authenticity. Bob Gibson. Probably worthless today. Here's another autograph card. This is Doug Davis. It's a rookie card, it looks like. Number 1206 of 1500. He's got his autograph right here. Congratulations, you have received a card personally autographed by Doug Davis. This trading card was sent to Upper Deck directly from Doug Davis. Their certificate expressly warrants the authenticity of the depicted athlete's signature. And this card was made by Upper Deck. Okay. And here's another Bob Gibson card with a piece of his jersey right here in red. And he got his 3,000th hit in July 17th of 1974. This card was made by Fleer in 2000, and it's number 45 of 55. Satchel Paige, pitcher for the St. Louis Browns. Topps Baseball Archives, the ultimate 1953 series. Old Satch. And this card is of Chipper Jones. And it's got his autograph on it. And it's made by Topps. It's a very good looking card. And Chipper was a 1999 National League Most Valuable Player. And at one time this card was valued at $120. Perhaps higher, but at the time I put this sticker on, it was $120. Here's another Roberto Clemente card. This one was made by Topps. The manufacturers had so many special cards, I can't even keep track of them all. Roberto Clemente. Bob Clemente. Now there's actually two cards in here. Roberto Clemente. Here's a Nolan Ryan card. And here's a Nolan Ryan book. Gary Sheffield, Upper Deck, at one time valued at about $120. Jack Morris, autograph card. Certificate of authenticity. Andre Dawson, autograph card. Cecil Cooper, autograph card. All these autograph cards are Fleer 2000. So Joe Here's a Mark McGwire card. This one was made by Stadium Club. And at one time was valued at $62.50. Now these cards, some of these values may have exceeded the sticker that I have on them, but at the time that I put the sticker on the card, that was the price, or I should say that was its perceived value by a magazine called Beckett that assigned prices to cards. Here's an Upper Deck autograph card. And this is pretty nice. Jim Palmer. And he played for the Orioles as a pitcher. Old Jim Palmer. And that is one of many rows to come. So I'm going to have to bring this video to a close. If you want to see more videos like this, be sure to tell me in the comments. Like I said, I could make so many of these. I could have a channel dedicated just to baseball cards. And I could probably make hundreds of videos. So let me know what you think in the comments. And if the feedback is positive, we'll go ahead and tackle row number 2. And then we'll move on and do all the drawers that are above this one. And we could go on forever and ever. Thanks for watching.